Clark's room.
How you doing? You're probably home right now doing your homework. Either that or watching soap operas, one of the two. Let's see, I guess we'll see you tomorrow and stay out of trouble.
Okay.
Hi, Roxy. You got to get your homework turned in on a regular basis. Other than that, you're doing fine this 9 weeks. No, classroom behavior, attitude is a lot better. But you got to do your daily homework, and you better study for that test tomorrow.
Okay, Roxy, you heard it from
Mr. Corley. Test tomorrow, chapter 3. Study your notes.
I didn't even have a meeting.
Gee, surprise, surprise. Now, what's this for? What are we on camera for?
Just to surprise them when they come home. You got anything to say to my three girls?
To your three girls? Now, who am I talking to? April, Roxy, and Lynn?
Uh-huh. You can start with April. That'd be a good one.
April, I can't wait to have you in class next semester. I'm gearing up for you, so you better be geared up for me, kiddo. And then I have Roxy. Miss Roxy this year. It's kind of quiet without Roxy. But she pops in every now and then to cheer me up. And Lynn, I'm keeping my tabs on Lynn. Tomorrow's our pizza party with Lynn, so...
Don't forget the pop.
Yes, don't forget the pop. Hopefully it's something that will agree with her. And look forward to that tomorrow. A big long weekend ahead.
Well, you girls all know who this is, so I don't even have to tell you. But
surprise, surprise for Mom.
Of course you know who this is. And you want to talk to April first?
Good. April's working hard and a real pleasant person in class. No problem with her. Just want to get her speed up. Everything else very organized, very well done, good habits. Roxy, we need to work harder. We need to get consistent. We need to get serious about some things. When that happens, you'll see an improvement in your grade because you're going to do better work.
All right. Now, you girls heard all this.
Heard it.
Straight from Mr. Hency.
We have a good class. We have a small, you know, there's only six of us in six of the class. That helps, too.
Yeah.
But I think they're learning some things, and they're starting to do better.
Do you recognize it, April, Roxy? You notice you're not here. But Mr. Hency still is.
Hi, girls. Hi. What's happening?
Got anything to say to Stacy?
You're sending this to Stacy?
Yep.
I thought you hadn't been in contact with her.
She just showed up a couple days ago.
You're kidding.
No.
So how's she doing?
Well, she plans on leaving and running away. Yeah. But maybe a few cheerful words from you will help.
Stacy, stay in school. Be good. Take care of that baby and get an education. I miss you and you can always write me. I love you. I miss your chocolate chip cookies. I burned my last batch. It was awful. Just awful. So.
Now her grades are good.
Oh, good.
Yep.
Great.
They've improved and she's working at McDonald's.
Good. But she can't run away.
Yep. That's what we've been
telling. What's going to happen to her if she does?
See you when you're changing another day. Don't work too hard.
Brian, this is the lady that always eyeballs you when you change.
Whole collection.
Check it out. Stacy, do you see yours up there anywhere?
The little yellow-haired one over here on the second shelf.
Now we're going to the second shelf.
In the pink outfit with the yellow hair. Right there it is.
Jade, I bet you'd like to have her as a teacher. Look at all these trolls. Jade's my 10-year-old. Look at that.
And that's the shelf I started out with. And then my little BB ones.
Yeah. See, her desk looks the same. No change. Oh, check out all the stuff.
We're into koosh balls this year. Koosh balls. Didn't even know what they were before. They're kind of a tension releaser. If you got to get somebody's attention, you just throw it at them.
She would, too.
I do. And then they throw them back.
Oh, is that what you're going
to
do?
Yep. Do you have anything to say to Roxy?
Oh, okay. We were just talking about Roxy, and she doesn't cause us any problems.
Now, you're sure you're talking about my Roxy?
Okay, I think so. Miss Reardon, what about her Roxy?
Okay, Miss Reardon, let's hear it.
I don't have any problems with it. She does her work, sits here, no problem.
She enjoyed having the classroom?
It's a pleasure.
Let's hear it.
I don't have any problems with it. She does her work, sits here, no problem.
She enjoyed having the classroom?
It's a pleasure. Pleasure to have her.
You realize that's natural blonde hair she has.
So is mine.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to head off here, Roxy. We're going to talk about you now.
Okay, well, what do you have to say? I'm looking for... I can't find...
Look who I popped in on in between classes.
What are you doing with that camera?
Taking pictures of a beautiful young lady sitting at a desk.
Nice. Well, you pass. You pass.
Got anything to say to my girls?
Hi, kids. This is me after hours.
No cookies on the desk?
Nothing.
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 That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
No pep talk for Lynn?
You better be doing your homework.
Okay, April, looks like she's about as chatty as you are. Go for it.
Hello, this is Mr. Stewart. I think you'll probably pass my class. Most people do. So you don't have to worry about taking it over again. I think that's about it. Thank you very much.
That's what April's room looks like in music appreciation class. And the teacher's laughing in the background and probably can't figure out what the heck I'm doing. By the way, he hides away in this little room and drinks coffee, April. And you still haven't returned his license plate either. But he doesn't say too
much. I told her just throw it out.
Oh, okay. Roxy, we're going to do you first, because we did April 1st last time.
Okay. Roxy, hi. You owe me bibliography and your outline for your persuasive speech. You also owe me review questions, chapter 13. You're doing fine in class, and as long as you get that in, I don't see any problems. Thank you.
Roxy! Okay, April, your turn.
April. Let me see. You owe me a theme narrative, which you knew that, and you also owe me a poem. You know that too, and I'm sure we'll get both those in. And your work to this point has been fine. Just get those two assignments in.
How did the girls do in class? Did they behave themselves?
Oh, yes, yes. April's very quiet, and Roxy is more social, but as soon as I ask her to be quiet, she's fine. So no problems out of either one of them.
Not bad.
I would like April to talk a little more, maybe. Other than that, that's fine.
I wouldn't. You'll hear her at home.
That's it.
Dad, you're going to be this gentleman who taught you.
Sure.
Are you sure he taught Dad?
Yeah,
hey, yes. Dad.
Dad, you really look old compared to this gentleman. I'm sorry. How's Roxy doing?
Roxy's doing better, but she could work a little bit harder, I think. Mm-hmm. Prepare for a test a little bit more.
Okay. Dad, you see this gentleman right here? He taught you in school. His name is Mr. Adsit. Do you remember him?
I'm very old now.
Honey, you look younger than my husband. Okay, Roxy, we're going to talk about the real truth now. Bye.
I'll see you in the restroom.
Yeah. Brian, go over by Mrs. Teufel.
Hello.
Come on, Big Red. Look at the Three Musketeers.
That's right. That's
restroom
right.
Buddies.
Well, he doesn't really.
I mean, outside the restroom.
That's right. Right here in the hall.
April, introduce this young man.
This is Mr. Hildebrand.
She's just Hello. Talking about you.
Who are you? You weren't in your room.
Geographic arts, huh? Mr. Shultz in graphic arts? How's it going?
Pretty good. I don't know what my grades are now, but it's going well.
Look at them, they split way far apart. They must be scared of each other.
I'm camera shy. I've always been camera shy.
Well, you look good on camera.
I take up a lens. I mean, we're talking telephoto, big lens.
Have you looked at her mother lately? If we have Barney in your locker.
Do you want me to go in there or not?
Hey, I wanted to see inside there. You have someone I'm not supposed to see? I don't want to see Barney, huh? There's no one in here.
No.
Where? Show me the dark room. Oh, right behind me.
Dark room. See? Dark room.
See the vent? All right, tell us all the horror stories that go on in the dark room.
You don't
want to know. If it's completely black and some people grab where they aren't meaning to.
Okay, this is Mr. Shultz.
Hello.
Hello, and how are you?
I'm fine.
Aren't I doing this in the right class?
Yes, this is in graphic arts, photography related, yes.
And how's this child right here doing in class?
She's doing fine.
Now, you're not just saying that because you're on camera.
Maybe, but no, she's doing very well. She got an A the last time, and I believe she's got the same going right now.
Just an A, April?
Oh,
she tried to do better, but... Yeah, she, as a matter of fact, she's got a perfect score right now, so.
Oh, that was boring. I'm into the dark room, kids.
Ooh, we can film the dark room. We can turn the light on.
Going into the dark room.
This is where she makes her pictures.
The dark room.
Well, guys, this doesn't look like April talked about.
No, when it's pitch black, it's really cool.
Where's your glow in the dark band-aid,
April?
Turn
on the red lights.
Blood and dark band-aid? It's all you got from
that. Well, that's no fun. Little brother over there. You tell him all about the dark room.
You put the negative in here and it shines down here really big.
Okay, and tell him what the other stuff is.
Yeah. Well, bring it over here and you put in the tray and then you put another tray and another tray and then you put in the wash tub. Then you put it in the dryer.
Show him the dryer.
Oh, okay.
This is April's dryer.
Stop, bath, and fixer.
That's a dryer.
It's a dryer.
Can't put too many clothes in there, can we?
Mom again with that camera.
Well, go stand next door, April. I'll get you with her.
That camera may end up in the courtyard. Just get off work. I look awful. Oh, yeah, you look nice. How are you, Brian? Good. Anybody ever seen me on this?
She's well, wearing normal clothes. Nice. It kills her.
She looks sharp.
She does.
Yeah.
She's
gonna watch it. Typical brother.
Well, yeah, he's dressed for work too.
Yeah, I was gonna say he looks pretty nice too.
Yeah.
Gosh, that's good.
Now, Lynn, we're not here to talk about you. You've noticed.
That's right.
Yep. So I hope you're doing good.
Doing your homework.
Oh, you want to give a little pep talk? You're allowed. I'm not. Go ahead, pep away.
Get it done. That's all the pep I need to give.
Okay, well, we'll let her off the hook. Give her a break here.
Oh, this is Macy's locker.
This number 116?
117.
Oh, wrong locker, guys. Mason's locker.
Macy's locker.
It don't look any different than any other locker, April.
Yes, you were just in here a few hours ago.
Okay, April, you want to introduce this young lady?
Miss Gibson.
And I have her down as Mr. Gibson on my paper.
It's Mrs. Gibson.
And how's this young lady doing in your class?
She's doing fine.
I'm doing awful.
No, she's my star student.
Well, we got two stories here, April. Are you doing awful or what?
I'm doing good. She's doing
I figured
very
you'd
well.
Want to change.
Weren't you my only A?
Yeah.
No, I had two A's. You and Jim.
I was the highest.
You had the highest.
Well, excuse me, April, you seem to know that.
97%. Jim only had 96%.
Jim who? Maybe we can pair you two up.
The Jim that I wanted you to try and get out of the home for a weekend.
Oh,
Jim,
that's him?
Jim Baker, yeah.
Yeah, she's real
she's
good.
She's cute. Trying to get her to get different kids.
Yeah.
Yes, I think you told me you had 13.
Yeah.
Yeah, she likes having kids. So do I, though. Well, I'm going to turn this off.
This is Chambers.
And
he wonders Hall's fourth period like I do.
That's right. What is this for? Practice?
Well, actually, it's blackmail.
Blackmail? Hey, no problem there.
Anybody in here with you?
Not yet.
No young
just
ladies. He's safe.
Right here?
Huh?
Just get your camera?
No, I've decided the younger kids always ask what the teachers look like here. So I'm filming a bunch
they
of them.
They want to know what we look like?
Mm-hmm.
What they have to look forward to.
What they have to look forward to?
Yeah,
this one beside me is the same way. Well,
you
looks like
Mr.
You're...
K's room with your camera next to
him?
One, two?
Yeah. You know where Mr. Karn went? He took off.
He went down the hallway not more than 2 minutes ago.
Just
missed them.
It's live. It's on film. Get done.
Oh, look at this. Look at them cookie eaters.
He ate the entire plate of cookies.
All of them. All of them.
Where did he disappear to?
I think she got it.
Look at these cookie eaters.
No crumbs in this one. Good.
Professionals in action.
Let's take it over.
I need a drink of water.
Professional educators in action. Everywhere. Eating cookies.
Here comes April with Mr. Karn.
We got him.
We've been looking for you, young man.
Oh, thank you.
Now, who's that again?
Mr. Montgomery. Remember him, our neighbor?
He's my neighbor.
Him?
That's Mr. Montgomery.
That's Mr. Montgomery.
That's Mr. Montgomery.
Hello, Mr. Montgomery.
Can you hear his dad's over here?
Oh, come here. Okay, can you hear his dad? Here we go. Okay, let's do
it. Bill,
put your hand in front of your legs like that.
There he is again.
Come on. I don't know what this is all about, but okay, enjoy yourself.
And how's she doing in class?
She's doing pretty good. She needs to work a little bit more when we get into groups. But she does a pretty good job on that. And she needs to talk in class a little bit more when she has questions or whenever she knows what's going on. Instead of waiting for somebody else, she needs to express what it is that she knows how to do.
And she's a good kid in class.
Yeah, she is. I should have done that, but yeah.
She's
Do you happen to know a person named Gary Pope?
Yes, I know Gary Pope.
What do you
I
know
had
about
Gary
this?
Pope about 100 years ago in school.
Was he a good student?
Surely he was.
She's lying.
I've seen his report card.
Dad, no. Do you remember this young lady here? Were you his English teacher?
Surely.
English
That's
teacher.
Right, but I did not know that you were Gary's wife.
But I know it's one of the unfortunate things that happened to me during life.
Right. Okay.
Now Gary's going bald, has 9 children, and... and 3 of them living out on their own.
Brothers, Gary and Steve. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Did you know Jane?
Tanya. Yeah. Tanya, all right. What's the other one?
Jane. She's the youngest.
I probably missed her.
Mm. No. See, honey, you could have had this as a teacher.
Right.
Well, I think we'll leave them alone now.
Shit.
We tortured her. You gave her gray hair.
All right.
See, she's leaving,
that.
Dad.
I don't
I'm going to turn it off. She's saying nice things about you.
Yep, that's Mr. Montgomery's dad and Macy's grandpa.
He looks ornery.
Don't worry, I guarantee you,
no.
Yes, you are now grounded permanently.
I'm not grounded. I'm a good kid. I'm the fastest typer. I keep
it. What? Are you going to be on TV, right? Oh, wait, she gets home. There's a message waiting for her on that kid video when she gets home.
See, he opened his mouth and won't put him on.
I think I have to make a phone call. That's right. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
If she's still alive.
If she's still alive.
I'm a good kid.
This is a high school all lit up. Isn't that neat? I don't know if you can see it, but it looks neat.
Yeah.